Let's talk about the election period, which will start on Sunday. First, let's start with clarifications.
Yes.
A lot of people might confuse the election period with the campaign period.
No. The election period is basically where some prohibitions start to be imposed. No? For example, the gun ban, prohibition to suspend local government officials, projects. Those are prohibited acts during the election period. The campaign period is when the candidates themselves are allowed to formally campaign for the position they're running for. That starts for national, it's 90 days before elections. For local, it's 45 days before elections.
So that means just because the election period will start on Sunday, it doesn't mean that candidates can already officially campaign.
Officially, that's the key word there. They can't officially yet campaign, but under RA 9369, they're not yet considered candidates for purposes of premature campaigning until the start of the campaign period. So technically, they can do whatever they want before the start of the campaign period.
Which, of course, is quite absurd because you cannot officially start campaigning, but you can already unofficially start campaigning.
The advantage here is that whatever expenses you have or incur before the start of the campaign period, that's not part of your official campaign expenses. So you're not required to include that in your statement of contribution and expenditures.
So advantage for what? For who?
For the candidates.
Who have money.
Definitely. So if you have ads or other campaign materials being done now, being produced now, you're still not required to declare that. But if you have one done within the campaign period, you're supposed to include that in your source. Okay.